Thank you. Thank you so much, Salim, for that really generous introduction. Welcome to all of you. Secretary Kerry is deeply disappointed that he couldn't be with us today. He did want me to thank all of you on his behalf and to express his personal solidarity with all of you for what you're doing in service to our country. I can report that the Secretary is doing well and is on the road to recovery, and not surprisingly, he is making the most of every minute and is continuing to push our ambitious agenda with our partners around the globe and making sure we all know what we're supposed to be doing back here, but we'll be eager to have him back. This room is named for a man who famously said that energy and persistence conquer all things, and I think that's an appropriate motto for all of the people who occupy it today. Consider the experience of GLIFA President Salim Ataturk. Over the past year, I've had the opportunity to get to know and work with Salim, and he told me how a decade ago he fell in love during his first posting to Seoul, and how when he returned home, he had to come alone because there was no way his partner could get a green card. Well, today, Salim's partner is also his husband, and he will soon arrive in the United States for training, so as they prepare to serve together at our embassy in Kabul. And it's a measure of Salim's character that throughout his effort to make things right for his family, he also worked alongside many of you to make things right for all families. That's how progress is made. I'm proud to work for a secretary who has also been fighting to make things right for LGBTI people and their families throughout the course of his career, from whichever perch he occupied. One of the issues he pursued as a senator, and one that Salim just mentioned, was passage of the Uniting American Families Act, and he took up the cause of a constituent named Tim Coco. Tim met Genezo Oliveira, a Brazilian citizen, while Genezo was visiting Boston in 2002. They fell in love and married in 2005. Unfortunately, at that time, federal law didn't recognize their union, so Tim couldn't sponsor Genezo for a green card. And as a result, Genezo was ordered back to Brazil in 2007, kicking off 3 painful years of separation. Genezo was unable even to join Tim for his mother's funeral. Tim and Genezo channeled their sadness and frustration into action, fighting to stay together by any means necessary. And for the better part of a decade, Secretary Kerry fought alongside them. He pressed the Attorney General to grant asylum to Genezo on humanitarian grounds. When that didn't work, he lobbied the Department of Homeland Security to grant humanitarian parole, which they did for 1 year. He wrote letters to senior officials, made countless calls, and even filed private relief bills on their behalf. So when Secretary Kerry stood before Embassy London in 2013, just weeks after DOMA was struck down, and announced that the State Department would treat the visa applications for same-sex spouses equally to those of opposite-sex spouses, I know that Tim and Genezo and all the loving couples that had been separated by borders and antiquated laws were in his thoughts. And speaking of antiquated laws and policies, when this group, GLIFA, first met 23 years ago in David Buss's living room, it did so in secret for fear of being closed down. And in 1997, when President Clinton nominated James Hormel to be ambassador to Luxembourg, the Senate Majority Leader compared homosexuality to alcoholism and kleptomania, and that was in public, in reference to a future ambassador. And that was the 90s, folks. It wasn't that long ago. So we've come a long way. But as all of you know, we still have more work to do. We've come from a time when GLIFA member Jan Kirch was kicked out of the Foreign Service in 1984, only 2 years after he joined, when it emerged that he was gay. Yet Jan never lost faith in his country, and he never gave up his dream to serve. Years later, after the rules were changed, Jan reapplied and rejoined the Foreign Service. Thankfully, there's been a fundamental shift, and now same-sex couples are recognized as a vital part of the State Department family. And today we recognize and salute GLIFA members like Carrie Hannon, who in Buenos Aires helped her ambassador illuminate the residents in rainbow lights, and Amanda Walters, who used GLIFA's small grants program to help a women's shelter in Bishkek build a more secure door to protect Kyrgyz women. Our same-sex couples serving around the world speak volumes about what it means to be American. Ambassador Ted Osius encapsulated this so well when he said, quote, "Here in Vietnam, I don't even need to talk about the diversity of the United States. Everyone here loves to take pictures. And when they take my photo standing next to my African-American husband and our Latino children, that's the picture of American diversity." At the State Department, we're committed to helping our families. all of our families. And that means opposing any effort by foreign countries to discriminate when issuing visas for the spouses of our personnel. We don't have gay spouses. We have spouses. We don't have lesbian families. We have families. And we refuse to accept that equal treatment by our foreign counterparts is too much to ask. As Salim mentioned a few weeks ago, at Secretary Kerry's instruction, I sent a cable to all of our posts seeking data that we can provide to our LGBTI colleagues to make informed bids about their next assignments. Those responses are nearly all in, and when that information is complete, we're going to take the next step and consider again the question of how we can push harder and smarter. Over the past year, we finally put an end to rules that required all federal health insurance carriers to discriminate against transgender persons. And I want to thank GLIFA and Undersecretary Pat Kennedy and the Office of Personnel Management for making the transgender exclusion a thing of the past. In February, President Obama appointed GLIFA member Randy Berry to serve as the country's first ever special envoy for the human rights of LGBTI persons. Randy knows the issues thoroughly, and he's helping to spread the word that regardless of past practice and cultural differences, it's simply wrong to pretend that people are criminals because of who they are or who they love. And equally wrong to pretend that people are not criminals when they inflict violence on others just because they are different in sexual identity or orientation. In making this case, we have to be persistent and persuasive. And it's doubly important that we do everything we can to help people like the courageous Pepe Anjibe from Uganda and Boysan Yakar from Turkey, who are both with us this afternoon. Pepe and Boysan, you are making a difference, and we owe it to both of you and to ourselves to stand with our brothers and sisters like you around the world who are on the front lines of this struggle every day, often at enormous personal risk. That's why we created the Global Equality Fund, a program to provide emergency and long-term help to people who are promoting the human rights of LGBTI persons in more than 50 countries. The fund includes governmental and non-governmental partners, including business and philanthropic organizations. I urge all of our partners around the world to support this worthy cause, and I'm pleased to highlight today that recent partnerships with Hilton Worldwide and the Human Rights Campaign will significantly amplify the fund's global impact. These partnerships will help launch new initiatives with the faith community and health sector with the overall goal of increasing allies who support the human rights of LGBTI persons. In closing, I want to thank all of GLIFA's members. Thank you for representing the United States at its best. Thank you for helping this department and other foreign affairs agencies to be their best. And thank you for reminding us that we can still be better. From those first meetings in David Buss's living room until today, you have helped demonstrate that energy and persistence and more than a little courage do indeed conquer all things. So I hope that we can continue working together in this effort, and I wish you a very happy Pride. Thank you.